Finally on Crossfire, and they can't make up their minds on which team
You
they on.
guys. No, you guys.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Who's it gonna be? Cause I hope Onyx stays on Blood Eagle. That way I don't need to change my setup.
So this is it. We're
Yep,
going live.
this is it. 6 seconds now. Alright, game one on Crossfire has just begun. LL Blue Jay is leading it up for Blood Eagle. Playing alongside him, Alakagon. Gosh, that name. Lion GG, Giga Laugh Bath, Mexico, Leech, Trism GG, Ripo 58. And why don't you introduce MIA's players?
No problem. MIA playing on Diamond Sword, we have Oz, Chromatic, Spawn, Ouch, Scorpion, Mr. Kibbles, Merix, Guru Izzy, that's what that says, Guru Izzy, and Vornsker. Sorry, they were moving around on the scoreboard while I was doing that.
Mm-hmm. Guru Izzy now with flag pickup. Ooh, pretty good clear. Sniped out though.
Looks like Leech got to pick up too, and is lombing it down the middle of the field. Him and Trizzy GG.
They've got a good chance to bring it back home.
Leech almost gets his own return, but misses it. Luckily, someone else picks it up, and it looks like this is going to be the first cap. Tosses it to the stand, and there we go. We have our first cap for Blood Eagle.
That's a pretty quick exchange there. See.
Yeah, very fast. Hopefully we'll see some longer runs, maybe a few standoffs. These two teams get warmed up.
Guru is, he has it again. He's moving around the field, just punting it right now, or a mispunt.
Yeah, flag just got through to the mid, sitting there. Looks like Mexico's gonna get it, but Oz is raising him to the flag.
No, it's pretty hard to score on Crossfire. So this early cap will no doubt help them out tremendously.
Looks like both squads are running one Sentinel, which, like you said, can make it very hard to cap on this map.
Mm-hmm. Trism GG's got it full health. Sleeping on that one.
Looks like he's going to make it back. Can he make it? Let's see. Is he going to punt it in? Oh, well.
Ooh, quick 2-0. Wow.
We have Onyx pulling out to an early lead here. Hopefully this thing can go a little bit longer.
It seems like they're constantly getting it off the stand here. It's just been, you know, minute 30.
Crossfire, they're just using that punt strategy. Just grab it, punt to your team, and keep running.
And they've got this capped out. A little miss on the front there.
Yep, a little miss on the toss of the flag stand, but they do get a third cap.
Hmm. see. They've got Fornski. How do you pronounce that name? Fornskjaer.
I'm looking right now. Vornsker, maybe? I don't know.
Yeah. He seems to be the only one on flag defense, and it's no wonder why they're not holding down their flag with only one person there and a sniper, but Trism GG now out in the
Looks
open
like
field.
We got Guru Izzy running a back to front right now. Let's see if he's successful.
Giga
Grabs
Laugh.
The flag with almost full health.
Ooh.
Gets killed midfield, but does do a successful punt. Meanwhile, Trism GG is back at the Blood Eagle base, ready to capture. They do get a return, but Spawn grabs it and jumps to stand.
Rippo.
Gets killed by Rippo.
Guru Izzy with pickup. Looks like we have a little flag standoff for just a second here. See how long we can hold on to it. A lot of pressure
Guru has
coming in.
Low health.
Guru Izzy is in the back of the spaceship, holding it. Gigalaugh Bat looking for an entrance.
Lion and Leech are on their way, trying to get a return here. Nice pass to Spawn, who has full health. Oh, he gets Nitron. It's bouncing on the ship. Let's see if they can get a return. Nope, looks like Diamond Sword is going to hold onto it for a little while longer. But Onyx does seem to be in firm control of this game.
They are... No, I believe it's MIA. It's... Oh yeah, it is Onyx. Never mind.
That, those switches confuse me too.
Okay. Yeah.
Not much pressure at all over on the Blood Eagle side. It looks like the chasers are just getting killed as they run in.
Mm-hmm. Looks like both teams have... Oh, Leech now. Oh, he misses his grenades. Well, gets a few shots in on Spawn. Putting a lot of pressure on him, but still alright. And just having so many defenders there makes it pretty easy to secure the flag, all things considered.
Oh, Lion's coming up from the back, barely misses. Oh, gets in with two chrome spin teaser discs. That was very nice.
They still hold on to it. Amazing.
Yep, Chromatic still has the flag with very little health. Gets taken out by a Raider Auto, looks like. Another quick pass. Spawn now has the flag. Back at the Blood Eagle base, still very little action.
Oz is trying to put some pressure in, but he's the only one up in the midfield for MIA.
As a Jug, I'm not sure how much success he's going to have getting that flag back without a Nitron with such a full Blood Eagle base.
Mm-hmm. Certainly, I think the Juggernaut... Oh, Leech now coming in as Infiltrator. None of the MIA players have noticed him.
Yep, Leech still is in that generator area.
Ooh, but Mexico with a nice little stealth play there. Managed to sneak in and take out the flag holder. Spawn, though, picks it up.
Looks like a couple more Onyx guys. Now I'm confused. Okay, a couple more Diamond Swords.
The flag is out in the open and looks like Guru Izzy. Oh, almost picks it up.
Yeah, very close.
Seems like Onyx.
Oh, they got a return.
Oh, well.
Here goes Cap 4. Let's see if they can make it there before they get an e-grab. Doesn't look like they're going to get an e-grab in time. There you go. 4-0 for Onyx. Pretty much right away here in game 1.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to see MIA definitely step things up. They're going to need to. They've definitely got enough time to swing things around, but it's going to take some definite changes of play.
Giga is coming in with a back to front right now. Has the flag. Let's see, he's not going too fast. Let's see if they can get a return here.
As following Kornski.
Oh, they're not gonna stop him, it looks like. And here comes cap number 5. I thought he missed, but it's just a little glitch. That's it for game one here between Onyx and MIA. 5-0 Onyx here on Crossfire.
Some really solid play there. Just allowing them to grab the flag with just about every single run.
Yes, Onyx definitely showing that they are a little bit more coordinated than MIA there in the first round. Hopefully MIA can step it up.
Alakabon with 14 kills there. Has been doing some really nice sniping that round. Barely had any time to get kills at all, but somehow... Oh, it seems like a lot of the Onyx players just racked up kills that round.
Yeah, I think that was mainly from the chasers for MIA trying to come back, or trying to come in and end that stalemate, but they were just not successful.
Mm-hmm. But you know, Arx Novena is a different map.
Very different map. You can see some of the similar punt strategy, but the terrain and the bridge in the middle do make for a slightly better, or a slightly different experience.
It is a lot farther between bases, which sort of hampers that a little bit. I've seen some teams do crazy strategies that should not work at all, but if you're dead stop, you can do stuff like that.
Oh yeah. So yeah, we are not going to be casting the game on here. They're just capping out so that no one gets disconnected. You know what the second round is going to be?
I do not. I was under the impression that they were just playing straight through.
I'm gonna try to get on Game Trainer real quick and see if it's posted on there. Let me know if it starts.
Might be catabatic, but I wouldn't wager much on that. Well, looks like we are on catabatic, I believe. Just holding up to let people join. Yep. It's an annoying little bug, but...
Round 2 will be on catabatic.
Mm-hmm. Don't worry, guys. Hopefully private servers being out tomorrow, I believe, will fix things.
Yes, we can only hope. I saw someone say that smoke bombs were going to be banned week 4. I found that kind of interesting.
Oh yeah. No, they're definitely. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a lot of sort of tentative changes to what people do play in comp play as. They sort of play more with the options of disabling different weapons, different loadouts. We'll see what that actually turns up.
I love visible specs. You can't tell who's there until people actually join teams. Surprisingly, there are quite a few people in this game that are under rank 30. Most of the time when I watch Tribescast or watch these scrims and matches, most of the guys are at least level 30, 35. So I'm glad to see that some of the less ranked players are starting to get into competition. Oh no, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, and you see Mooncon over on Diamond Sword rank 16. So yeah, definitely rank is not an indicator of skill, but it is an indicator of how much you play. So a lot of the guys that are on the really good teams have played a lot more than anyone else. Hey, my roommate is telling me that on the stream he can only hear my voice and not yours.
Convenient. I had myself muted
Yeah.
there for a second, so interesting. But we should be good to
10 seconds
go
until deployment.
shortly.
Yeah, he says you're good to go. How long were you muted for?
Five,
I don't think very long.
All right, that's good.
So after that short round before, we're into game two on Katabatic.
Yes, here we go. Game two on Katabatic Onyx. First MIA. Hopefully we will have a bit of a longer game than we did in the last round. That was a quick 5-0 for Onyx.
We've only got two people on flag defense right now. Still, so curious why MIA would up their low emphasis on defense after last round.
Yeah, we'll just have to see how these strategic decisions that they make play out. It looks like Lion is going to get a cap here, or maybe Trism after clearing out the flag stand. Trism does have one of those heavy as light bugs. I don't know if you can see that, but on my screen he's looking light, but he's definitely a jug.
Flag is out in the open, and Trism GG has it. He may just be able to take it up the middle, as there's nobody except for Scorpion there to gun him down. Mora comes in though, very quick grab. Lion GG now in the open field. Merrick's misses a snipe on him.
I don't see anyone from MIA in position to get an e-grab. Oh wait, Guru come in from the back. Is he gonna get there in time?
Oh.
Barely, but Lions kills him just as he picks it up. Lions going for his own return, tosses it to Mexico, and there we go. Quick cap number one.
Again, this may be a very short match. Leech putting pressure in, playing as the Raider. Scorpion at half health.
Looks like Giga is coming in on a side route, grabs it, and is heading over the hill with a chain gun, closely following him behind.
More chasing after, not quite landing his shot.
Amor is the only one in position to get a return, but he has very low health. Let's see if Giga can turn around and shoot him, or is he just going to make a run straight for the flag?
LL Blue J takes him out. Flag is, though, in the open. No returned.
Chromatic is in position to possibly get an e-grab here. Let's see if he goes for that, if he just tries to kill Giga. Nope, Giga gets another cap. Oh, and Trism is there immediately to get a fresh grab as soon as they get that cap. So Onyx definitely having their way here with MIA.
Punts at midfield, and looks like Tristram's mixing it up. He was in Pathfinder there. Oh, but now it's your
Oh, nice
turn.
returner. Yeah.
Yeah, a little surprising the way things going, but glad to see. We may have some worthy action here.
Yeah, for once, we actually have both flags on the stand here in this match between these two teams. Let's see if Lion can get another grab, or if, who is that, Mooncon or Chromatic can get a grab over on the Blood Eagle side.
Trism GG though coming in for a quick grab from behind. Catches Scorbunn completely unaware.
Yep, Trism's got good speed here, heading back over halfway to the base. Mexico is off. And yep, that's gonna be a third cap quick there for Onyx.
Very interesting to see. Positions. Merrick's is picked for sniping. He's just picked complete midfield.
Spawn Ouch just somehow got the Blood Eagle flag way off into the side of the map, and looks like he might get away from Trism here for the first Diamond Sword cap of the matchup. Let's see if he can do this.
I think he's going to get Nitron. No, miss on the Nitron. Still making her way. Nitro does go in. Trism does pick it up for the save. They're getting closer.
Yeah, hey, that was a much better attempt than we have seen in the past. So hopefully they can take that strategy and improve on it.
Maybe their time's out though. Strikes out. Mexico piloting it. No, just buying it for Lion GG.
It'll be interesting to see if they go for some crazy strike flag grabbing antics or if this is just a traditionally defensively used strike. Although he is using it for offense right now, huh?
Trism coming in, picks it up, and he's got
Yeah,
good
Lion
speed and.
with a great clear there with the strike and perfectly timed it for Trism to come through and get a nice high speed grab.
Yeah, he's way. Nobody's chasing him.
Spawn looks like he's the only one who might be in position to get an e-grab, but instead he chases Blue around that center mountain. Oh, gets sniped out by, who was that?
Merrick's
Merrick's. Yeah, great shot.
finally picking it out. Gigalath has it. Drops it though. Interesting, picks
Yeah, it
it
looked
back
like that
up.
was an attempted pass to Trism, but then when he realized that it wasn't going to go and Moore might get it, he just went ahead and picked it back up again, even though he had such little health.
They do,
Mexico with the
however,
flag. We'll see if he
they
can get
did
it back
manage
for the
to, in
fourth
that
cap.
hectic to return their own flag. Ooh,
Yeah, I
as
missed
though,
that. Thanks for pointing that out.
with the e-grab. Makes a nice punt.
Hunts it to Guru. Let's see. Yep, Guru picks it up and he is gonna go for some long back route. He is Spin Fuser jumping, so hopefully he will get away from Rip. Let's see.
Doesn't quite have the HP from those spin jumps, and they definitely didn't get him moving the way he wanted to go.
Chromatic did manage to kill Blue while he had the flag, but there were three other bloody players there ready to pick back up. Blood Eagle does manage to get the return. Mexico on his way to the fourth cap, barely misses but tosses it up to the stand, and there you go, fourth cap there for Onyx. It's looking like we might have another shutout here on Katabatic, but we'll see. Hey, you never know.
Anything could happen, definitely with 17 minutes left. We're definitely
Correct.
seeing a lot of unselfish play coming out of Onyx. They're just always passing the flag to each other.
Absolutely. Definitely one of the keys to success is good flag passing.
Gigalath Bath looking for the run on the flag stand. It's completely open.
Oh, and Trism gets it just before he does.
Well, forget what I was saying about being unselfish.
Yeah, right? Well, hey, I mean, I think Trism was probably running a slightly better route. He is going pretty fast here.
And he's going to come in for the quick 5-0. Good game.
So, 2-0 here for Onyx over MIA. We are still going to be moving on to the third map because this is a Game Shrine match.
Yeah, we'll see what map that is. Sort of hard to tell.
I personally like to see Rain Dance, but I'm not sure if that is in the Game Shrine
I don't right believe now. It is. I guess we're seeing. I have no idea.
Dry Dock, isn't it?
Dry Dock, Dry Dock. Have you gotten the chance to play much on Rain Dance?
Have I played much on Rain Dance?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have. On pubs, it's definitely an interesting experience. A lot of people don't quite know how to move around on it at this point, and I have also seen a lot of turtling, which is just kind of unfortunate. It makes for some boring games. But I have also had some very fun, fast-paced games on Rain Dance, so it can go either way. It just depends on how people are going to play.
Yeah, my typical experience from it is just people hunker down on flag defense, and you'll have a majority of the team guarding that flag stand.
Oh yeah, I've been in quite a few games where two or three Doombringers just make it their job to regulate on that flag stand, and as someone who has been practicing capper, I'm definitely not the best capper, but it can be incredibly frustrating when they have an excessive amount of Doombringers on Rain Dance.
Mm-hmm. It definitely takes some coordination that's hard to find in the pubs.
Oh yeah. Capture and hold, however, on Rain Dance, I think, is a ton of fun because you're less prone to that whole camp thing. Well, it's kind of camp the game mode, but you have 5 points to camp instead of just 2, so.
It's Dry Dock. So again, we're just waiting for maps to rotate, players to join back in.
But tomorrow, this will no longer be a problem because we'll be able to rotate maps through the console and just won't be an issue anymore.